Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, A Tear of Vermillion, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, now heading towards Dorx. Icon Passage. So we have Gawain and Rutice in the party. Eventually, I guess we're taking a ship from Dorx to go to this island to try to get or find out where to get the sacred treasures of Barnes. Oh, this thing wants to attack us. This will be interesting. Gambler Squid. They like to gamble. Just be sure to keep your poker face on and we'll be good to go. There, she says. Yeah, they didn't hurt him. Didn't hurt the others, though. Oh, wait. I was used to Gawain being the second one. Hold on a second. Okay. You attack this. You attack this. Gawain most likely can one-shot this. See what I mean? Oh, she's got white magic too. But Gawain has significantly more magic points than Rutice. Which way? Well, this seems to be a dead end. There's a monstray there. This goes around. Oh wait! Chest. One of those dead ends with a chest. Awesome. We got another rara potion. Nice. How are we going with the potions? I never buy them, just so you know. I just collect them. Got 9 rare potions, 8... No, sorry, 9 rare potions, 8 rarer potions, and 1 rarest potion. Which I never have used it a single time. Alright, so we're continuing this way then. These things are scared of us. Oh, we'll kill them another way. We tagged your bot. Thank you, Abby Pet. Oh, you should feed that thing. Zero. Missed. You're doomed. Yes, this is exciting because this is episode number 49. So next episode is gonna be an extra long. 50th episode. Yay! Feels like we can walk up here. No? No. Now it goes off. It's probably the way we're supposed to go, but there might be a chest or something over this way. There is! Yay! A claymore. I don't think we'd sell that. That's not as good as what we're using, is it? Oh, Avin's using a claymore now. Rutish doesn't use swords. Gawain doesn't either. Okay. Yeah, if I remember, I'll sell the claymore. Well, let's kill this thing. You're bothering me just wandering around like this. You must die. Oh, his meter's full. You gotta see how his, we got interrupted? Oh, he didn't make it there. You gotta see how his, what do you call it? His finishing move is. Maybe the next battle. I'm sure it's gonna be overkill. Alright, we're going up this way. It's a good song. Bring it on, stinker! Alright, so Meteor Breaker. Unless there was something nearby would attack that well as well, but Sage of Strength is just named Meteor Breaker. I think it's spelled wrong, it's supposed to be Meteor Breaker. Yeah, it's like 300 points or something. Pretty crazy. Which way? Knuckles off. Maybe this is a dead end with a nope, it's just a dead end. It's like almost far enough up the screen to see that it ended there. Oh, Dorx! That's funny, there's no... Gawain says, this is Dorx. A boat must be waiting for us. This is the first time. Never seen a little sign outside the village or town, city, whatever. When did you arrange it, S. Avin? Priest Quar... Quar? I don't know how to say that. Prince Quar sent a messenger. When we're ready, we'll go to the North Pier. We're not ready. There are people to see, and that's about it. Aiden says, you must be the people from the Bardis Church. The paladins have been waiting for you at the North Pier. You're going to study the ruins on the island, aren't you? You've come here many times already, but couldn't find anything. Tough luck. I guess he's talking to Gawain. Because, those barrels are distorted. Because Avon's never been here. Lila says, we're having difficulty going to Theta to purchase merchandise ever since the monsters began showing up along the highway. I hope the paladins will exterminate the monsters. Gawain says, please be patient for a while. The paladin army is now patrolling the highway. Hello. I said hello. Kikkel says, hi, I haven't seen you around here. Welcome to Dorx, the northernmost fishing village. Okay. Protective walls. You can run around here. Oh. We don't need that, you stinker. Tool shop owner. Hi there, we have useful tools here. So you claim. It's a rather boastful claim. I don't know if you... We don't use these talismans and stuff. Oh, Karamas. I managed to get rid of Geomane and came here to look at the Northern Sea. How shall I put it? It's a very lonely place, much more than I had expected. Is it you, Mr. Karamas? Says Avin. Huh? Hi, Avin. I didn't expect to see you here. Where's your partner, that boy with golden hair? Well, something happened. What's wrong? You can tell me if you like. If it makes you any better, you can damp it on me. What? Dump it? Dump it on you? God, damp it on me. I think I should, says Avin. Avin told him about the adventures he had experienced. I see. You've had such a painful experience. I don't know what to say. Mr. Karamas, I just... Don't worry. I won't use what you've just told me in my book. I've done many things I'm not proud of, but I'll never trample my friend's feelings. No, that's not what I wanted to say. You can go ahead and use it in your novel. Your novel is a testimony to my journey with Mile. I'm sure Mile won't say no either. I see. Okay. If you say so, I'll put all my dedication and effort to make Quick Raven a great masterpiece. I'm looking forward to reading it. Oh, a flame of creativity began burning inside me. A fountain of literary art is springing up, an endless flow of water. And now, yes, it's coming. I must write. He says that every time. Good luck. Count on me. I'll write a great novel to take Elfilden by storm. Don't lose heart. Neil says, a warm current and a cold current meet off the coast of Dorx. It's a perfect fishing spot because the small fish grow fast and attract the big ones we're interested in. Okay. Kirche? Says, don't open the barrels kept outside. The fish sauce is not ready yet. The fish sauce. Old Woman Hine says, fish around here has firm meat, perfect for making a flavorful fish sauce. You can't have this flavor anywhere else but here in Dorx. Old Man Cabal says, the ruins of the legendary tribe are left on the Truth Island. They were reportedly built around 1,000 years ago, but no details have been known. Sometimes the church sends researchers. By the way, you look tired. Why don't you take a rest for a while? It doesn't fit in the thing. Yeah, let's take a rest. It's free, after all. If you're tired, just come back. You're always welcome. Thank you. Hello? Silk says, men catch fish at sea, and women make fish sauce in the village. That's the way of life in Dorx. Sounds thrilling. Radial says, a milk-colored fog is covering the area north of the Truth Island. Once you're in it, even a veteran sailor gets lost. We call it the Sea of Fog among the fishermen. Is there anything beyond the Sea of Fog? Like another world? Or perhaps heaven? Maybe Liberal is beyond there. That's a wall. Alright, so we got this. This. There's a wall here. And we can't get through there. I think we've about... This is that same guy, right? Oh yeah, Karamas. Pesca says, my father tells me to become a fisherman, but I want to see what's there beyond far sea. I also want a challenge to see a fog off the island coast and the vortex of chaos in the southern sea. The vortex of chaos. The place I want to go most is the giant cleft in the ground at the east end of this world. It's called Gagarv. Many sailors have tried in vain to cross Gagarv. It's every man's dream to have adventures at open sea. Well, somehow I don't think it's every man's dream. So are these all distorted because they have fish sauce in them? So I guess we're done exploring. This is what I was about to say. We've reached the end of the village. The paladin says, "We were waiting for you, Sage Gawain. Thank you for your service. We didn't know you were accompanying a girl." Gawain says, "She's traveling with us now. I hope the boat is large enough to carry one more person. The sea is calm. The boat should sail smoothly, carrying three persons. Would you like to leave for the Truth Island right away?" Yeah, let's leave right away. Nothing else to see here. "So long," says Gawain. I think that's a yes. Up. "Please be careful." "Don't tell us what to do." "You're discharged from service, young man." The boat doesn't even have to turn. Just skirts along sideways. Boop! Okay. It's a very weird sound. Or music, song, whatever. Avin says, "So these are the ruins of an ancient civilization. Do you know how old they are?" Gawain says, "Probably 1,000 years old. They were built by the Blue Tribe that lived in ancient times. After Bardas and Octomed entered their eternal sleep, the Blue Tribe ruled the world. These ruins are the legacy of their prosperity." "So what happened to the Blue Tribe?" "Some say the tribe perished following a disaster they brought upon themselves. Thereafter, the Bardas Church and Fildon family gained power and wrote the history of El Fildon as we know it today. Now, few people know about the Blue Tribe." "A forgotten tribe," says Rutis. "I feel very sad for them." Gawain says, "The power they left behind is our only hope now. There's an entrance to the ruins on the north side. Let's go." Well, I'm gonna look around. I can't go that way. Oh. Oh, you found something. It disappeared so quickly, though. Oh, it goes away. Look at that. It's supposed to last longer than that. Oh, there's the entrance. Well, I guess there's nothing else around here to see. Alright. Gawain says, "These doors lead us into the ruins." "They're pretty big," says Avin. "The doors are not locked, but they're very heavy. I'll push the right door, so you push the left one." "Okay." "Can I help?" asks Rutis. "You help Avin. He hasn't done this before. He needs all the help he can get." "Help the sage," says Avin. "You're not young anymore. We don't want you to get hurt." "Well, well," Gawain says. "What?" "So, what should I do?" asks Rutis. "Just stay there and observe," says Avin. "Don't help us," says Gawain. "Oh, okay." "Wah!" yells Avin. "Hum!" yells Gawain. "Stay there and observe, huh?" "I opened it first," says Avin. "You're mistaken. I was quicker." "They are two of a kind," says Rutis. "Shall we go in?" asks Avin. "Right. Let's go." How exciting. We're now inside the ruins, says Avin. The interior is well preserved. Gawain says, it proves the superb construction technology of the Blue Tribe. There's a place in the basement that looks like an altar. If we're lucky, we may be able to receive a revelation there. Okay. Well, there's only one way to go. Oh, wow. We don't need that. At least we're able to get it this time. Alright, let's go down this way first. Oh. Still don't need it. Nope. Dead end here. Good song. Yay! Rare potion. So this is where it came in? Yeah. Well, came down. I think we've been over. Yeah, we've been over here. Okay. So we have to go around this way. Oops. This is a dead end. Yeah. Goes down even more. Let me just check over here in case there's a chest or something. Nope, dead end. And hopefully we found what we're supposed to find. We won't have to manually walk out of here again. That'd be cool. Oh, the music stopped. Oh. Now we have awe-inspiring holy music. It's probably over there. Oh, there's another way. Is that way? I'm just looking around, looking all around. We can go under that. To me, it sounds like music that's like, you're looking at something so beautiful, it's like heartbreaking in its beauty. Avin says, look! Oh! Madrim! Oh no, that's not Madrim. Man in a robe. A white dragon and a black dragon. It's a marvelous mural. Is that, what's his name? Marty? Perhaps they represent... Gawain says, Bardas and Octum, this mural is said to depict the battle of light and darkness. The people who drew this must have seen dragons in the supreme existences who resorted to violence. I see, says the man in the robe, I think is Marty. To them, Bardas and Octum were nothing but a source of terror. I thought these ruins were long forgotten, but they do have visitors. I'm sorry I came in without permission. Gawain says, the Truth Island doesn't belong to anyone. You don't have to apologize to us. We were also surprised to see you here. So this place is called Truth Island. It sure is a suitable name. There are places like this where I came from. I felt the same aura and dropped by. Gawain says, well, I've never heard of other places like this. Oh. I haven't introduced myself yet. Oh, is it not? Marty, never mind. My name is... Michel, I guess? Michel de Lap Heaven. Michel, Gawain says. My name is Gawain. I'm an advisor to the Bardas Church. They are Avin and Rutis. The Bardas Church I see. I guess he mutters, it seems faith is still left in this world. Then there may be a group that worships Octum. What are you murmuring? Asks Avin. Nothing. Just a trivial thought. I have a question, says Arutis. The entrance to the ruins was closed. Where did you come in? She's right, says Avin. Two of us had to push the doors open.
That's right.
Well, I managed to close the doors myself. I couldn't let salty wind enter and destroy such a precious monument. I've tried too hard and pulled a muscle. Ha ha ha. Embarrassed laugh. Everyone's silent. Avin and Rutis kept staring at Michel with suspicious eyes. I guess you don't believe me, huh? How can we? Says Avin. Are you a member of Octum's apostles? Rutis says, I don't remember him under Master Belius, but I do feel extraordinary power from him. Gawain says, you two, that's enough. I don't see malicious intent in Michel. He won't hurt us. Thank you for trusting me. Well, they didn't. I guess he's talking to Gawain. You must have come here to receive a revelation. I shouldn't get in your way. I'll back off. Avin says, who is that man? Gawain says, he does bother me too, but we have things to do first. Avin, place Cabessa and Kurupo on the crest. If we're lucky, we may be able to receive a revelation. Hopefully Michel doesn't steal them, because I don't trust him. Alright, says Avin. We need the other treasures, though, don't we? Nothing's happening. Everyone's waiting. In silence. Why? Says Avin. Nothing is happening, says Rutis. Gawain says, something is lacking, but what is it? The other four treasures, duh. If I may, says Michel. Are you in trouble? I may be, may be able to help you. Grab the treasures, Avin. Help us? You? Avin says. Gawain says, well, are you familiar with the ruins of the Blue Tribe? Where I come from, ruins like these are called the Shrines. They are the destinations of pilgrimage. Oh yeah, like in Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. The powers of the shrines manifest easily in the holy maidens and children. We have an innocent mind, but it requires some tricks for us to see the powers. Gawain says, I see. Please help us then. I'll try. Avin says, can we trust him? I don't know, Avin. Gawain says, we don't know his true identity, but he doesn't seem to be lying. We should let him help us. Michel says, close your eyes and relax your mind. Open your mind's eyes and try to picture the sacred treasures on the floor. Our mind's eyes? Says Avin. How can we do that? Just try, says Rutis. Michel says, good. It's working. It is? What's he doing? Avin has an obvious change in his expression. It began, says Gawain. Wow. Where are we? Avin says, I can't believe that I can see things so crystal clear. Rutis says, so this is the power of the Truth Island. Who are these kids? Avin asks, but where is this scenery? Spelled wrong, anyway. Gawain says, a house on a lake. It's probably the village of Quit. many of these kids running around. Can she see us? It's like she saw something for a second. The third sacred treasure, says Avin. It's like by a depression in the ground. Rutis says, it's a strange place. Gawain says, it's probably Garden Hill, otherwise known as the Garden of the Gods. Is that Michel? Well, there's another treasure. Avin says, oh, the lookout cottage? Oh, wow, yeah, there's a scarecrow. Gawain says, so, this is where Sir Lemurus used to dwell. There's another sacred treasure here? The ruin located north of the lookout cottage. Mile and I used to play there. So up to five, we need to find one more. Well, we're not finding it. Is this a graveyard, Esrites? We're being shown where it might be. That looks like Madrim. Was it? Is that where the first, well, not the first, but the other Durga's daughter is buried? 15 years ago. That's all the treasures. And a sword. Is there a sword of Bardas? Reality. Avin says, so that's it? It was the revelation. Rutis says, we've learned where the sacred treasures are, but what's the meaning of the last sword? That's what I'm wondering. Gawain says, the ruins of the ancient people gave us more clues than we had expected. Let's go back to the Grand Cathedral in Valkt. We should consult Priest Quar first. By the way, says Avin, who was that man? Hey. He's gone. I don't feel him anywhere, says Gawain. He must have gone. He was a man of tremendous power. Rutis says he sounded like he wasn't from Elfilden. Not from Elfilden, Avin says. What's that mean? Well, this Michel person, says Gawain. I have a feeling we'll see him again. At brink of despair, due to having his friend lost and his sister kidnapped, Avin reaches Truth Island, an island with ancient ruins. There, Avin witnessed an image showing the location of the sacred treasure of Bardas and a mirage of a sword glittering in a platinum light. What this all meant is unknown, but there is hope that the shattered bonds can be reunited by collecting the rest of the sacred treasures. On his way back from the island, Avin takes out the bell, now his only link to to memories of Mile. The calm tingle of the bell reassures Avin as the boat drifts across the deep blue sea. Chapter 3, Bond Location. Oh, you're back, says Priest Crier. We just came back, says Gawain. Crier says, so, how did it go? Gawain told him what they saw on the Truth Island. Is that so? Says Quarer. As long as I heard your story, it looks like the rest of the four treasures are hidden in the shrines of four great spirits. I think I've heard that before, says Avin. There are the four elements of nature connected to Durga. Eden of gentle wind, Scotia of pure water, Nephthys of the harvested land, Zar of the raging fire. Avin says Nephthys was the spirit worship at Ort Village. I remember that something like the Eden Festival was held at Borin, too. Gawain says, people are familiar with the four great spirits as an object of a simple folk belief in various places of Elfilden. As a religious symbol, the shrines have existed since ancient times. Avin says, so the sacred treasures are hidden in those shrines. Gawain says, while we pretty much know where the sacred treasures are, we still have the problem with the silvery white sword which just appeared. As far as I'm concerned, it will be faster to ask Sir Quarr's opinion. Quarr says, there is a quote in the old scripture of Bardas. A shattered piece of Bardas will dwell within a sword that is harder than steel and lighter than a feather. Wow, really, lighter than a feather. And it will become a streak of light that will drive away great darkness. It will be called Sacred Sword Illusion. The one who obtains this sword will... No, I shouldn't say any more. Avin says, well, whatever. But if I had that sword, even I could break the barrier, right? But I think it will take more than merely collecting all the sacred treasures to produce the sword. Gawain says, we might need to prepare another sword to let the power of the sacred treasures dwell in. By using materials which are harder than steel and lighter than feathers. Rare metal, right? Does such a metal exist? Asks Avin. Rare metal, says Rutis. What? There is a metal called rare metal. I heard that Lord Belius ordered Borgi to mass-produce it at the factory in Guia. Yep. It's light like a feather and stronger than steel. Avin says, when I come to think of it, the plant manager was saying something like that. That's what those guys were coming along to harassing him about. Rutis says, rare metal easily soaks up spell powers. By some chance, it may draw the power of God. It's said that it's hard to refine, so even a single knife is difficult to produce. Gawain says, I guess it's worth trying. Leave that rare metal to me. Gawain? Asks Avin. I'll explain our situation to the plant manager of Guia and see if he can cooperate with us. By the way, I want to visit Sir Denurkin in Prayer Woods and consult him about this matter. My god, we're really going all over, aren't we? So, Sir Quarr, says Gawain. Quarr says, don't worry about us. You trained the paladin to be very strong. I appreciate it. Avin, Rutis, we are counting on you guys to get the sacred treasures. Avin says, yeah, trust us. This is something I have to take care of anyway. Oh, is Gawain not coming? If the four great spirits possess the sacred treasures, most likely you will face some difficulties. But no worries. All you have to do is remember the teachings of Sir Lemurus. Avin says, real strength means to possess power, wisdom, and compassion, right? Gawain says, I won't say anything if you know it. I'll wish you the best of luck. Don't leave us, Gawain! He's such an energetic man at his age, says Avin. Quarr says, we owe Sir Gawain a great deal. Without him, the Bardas Church would have been ruined when the cathedral was captured. Anyway, About collecting the sacred treasures, you should first go to the village called Quit in the west of the Holy Capital. In the west of Holy Capital, says Avin says. I heard that Quit appeared first in the vision you saw on the Truth Island, too. It may be better to visit the places as you saw in sequence. Okay, I'll take off right away. I'm counting on you. By the way, Rutis. Yes. The Bardas Church and the Octum's Apostles have been fighting for so long. But I recently wonder how much meaning this battle has. There are oracles in the Bardas Church who only think of filling their own pockets. There is someone like you in the Octum's Apostles who is working so hard for an ideal world. I don't know which one is right as a human. Does that mean right as a human? Rutis says, yeah. I haven't been able to know what's right since I left the Octum's Apostles. But there is one thing I know for sure. That is, I haven't thought about things using my own head. I totally believed in the given doctrine blindly and acted as if it was my own opinion. I was nothing better than a puppet. I think it was far from how a man should be. Well, you're not a man. Haha, it makes sense, says Quar. You seem to be making some good points. I think you'll be able to find your own right path without being deceived by darkness or by believing light blindly. Will you please guide this young man step by step when he gets lost? I think you overestimate my abilities, but I'll do as much as I can if the opportunity comes. Thanks, you. Thanks, you. I wish you the best of luck on your journey. Please be careful on your way. Okay. First, you should go to Moss Lake. There's a small village called Quit by the lake in the west of the Holy Capital. The water spirit Scotia's shrine is very close to the village. Moss Lake... Quit. Okay. Alright, well that'll be next episode with the huge, extra-long episode, 50th Anniversary Celebration. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you then, and always, sick adventure.